Stella went to sleep in peace, sharing her days and special moments with her father, the moon. Next day, she cleaned on her own, packing all the things she had outgrown. Many toys, clothes, bedspreads, shoes, all her precious belongings that were hoarded, found place into a huge basket. With her parents' permission, she went along with her nanny to share them at the god's palace. She thanked the residents for accepting the things. They were new, well taken care of. The residents expressed joy, blessing her with prosperity. Her learning from life was to love herself. Hoarding, comparing, hurt, anger, fear had melted away, giving space to joy, love, and compassion. Her being sang to the trees, birds looking up at the sky. I have been standing strong, tall, and rooted for more than 100 years. I had seen Stella's father's childhood, while the Mother Earth kept me firmly grounded. The sky gave me life with sunshine and rain. I was the first one to see Stella. Both the sky and the earth had chosen the house where I stood. Stella saw me every morning. The birds had the witness bent on me. During spring, the flowers that bloom split fragrance in the air. My leaves were green. The dry ones fell on the ground, giving place to the new ones. Life is effortless for me. I only witness all that happened. I did show Stella, be it summer, winter, spring, or rainy. All seasons passed by, making me stronger. Stella loved me. She hugged me and spoke to me kindly. I let her swing from my strongest branch. She always asked me before she sat on the swing. The words she always said to me was, "You shower abundance, love." As she says that in joy, I shower her with petals of flowers and leaves.